All right, welcome back to the Riz Show. Our phone number 314-969-DUDE, 314-969-3833. We got a guest here. Mr. Marc Lillibridge is here.
Hey,
what up, man?
Hey, good morning. Happy birthday, Jeff.
Bridge is a former NFLer. I mean, how many teams have you played for?
Four in the NFL. And then I was a scout for the Packers. I was a scout for the Chiefs. Then I was a sports agent for a long time, for over 10 years. So
sports agent?
Yeah, so I've done it all, man. Yeah.
All right, there, Arliss.
Yeah, you
anybody remember that show?
I think we all know I'm more of the rock and baller.
Right.
But that's fine. I mean, whatever. You can
remember Arliss?
Oh, yeah.
Great show. Robert
Wool.
Sign,
right?
Yeah. You're Robert Wool.
Great show.
That was a great show. That was HBO, like, way back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, original programming before the Game of Thrones stuff.
That was like right around Real Sex 4. I mean, they were right around there at that time.
It was Arliss was on.
What
was
I didn't see. That's why I never saw Arliss, I don't think, Jeff.
It was Real Sex the entire time, right?
It was Arliss. And what was the other show they had on HBO? Showed a lot of nudity. It was a lot of nudity.
On HBO?
HBO. It was one of their original.
That was Showtime.
It was one of their original. One of their original programming.
Emmanuel
shows. No, stop it.
Emmanuel in Paris.
Yeah. See, I couldn't afford HBO, so I don't really know what you're talking about.
On an NFL salary, you couldn't afford HBO?
Times
have changed.
I think you're talking, the shows you're talking about probably in the 90s, and that's when I was in college and stuff, so no, I couldn't afford it. But yeah, no, I have no idea.
Perversions of Science?
No.
Tales from the Crypt? The Hitchhiker?
No.
Ray Bradbury Theater?
No.
A Little Curious.
Oh. So bummed.
It was about a guy. It was a guy, and he'd have sex with a lot of chicks.
Was it drama or comedy?
It was kind of a drama.
You're not thinking of Californication, are you?
No.
But it was like,
that was
before
on Showtime.
That,
right?
But
it was
same
way before.
Kinda,
I was still
same
in high school.
Kind of character.
It was, in the same
vein, if you will.
Same, yes. Yeah.
Dream on.
Dream on.
Damn it, anyway.
That's
damn
the
it.
Show.
You don't got to yell.
Who was the dude? Who was the main guy?
The dude was.
It was a
Ryan Benben.
Yeah, well.
I don't know him.
I have no idea. I've never heard of
Chris
that show.
Chris Dimitro, Denny Dillon.
Denny Dillon, that's it.
Well, if there's there's anybody to make football picks and to help you out with your draft, some predictions for, the season, it's Bridge over here. The guy knows his stuff.
Well, hopefully you've already had your draft. If you're drafting today, you're probably behind the
eight
ball. But you should have can help you set your lineup. So we know some football.
Well, Moon, for the first time, is in a fantasy football league.
Yeah.
And take a look at his roster.
He did. He goes, oh, boy, we got to talk about this.
It's tough. I mean, there's the one of the things is he's got three quarterbacks. You don't need three quarterbacks in your roster.
Okay, my starter got injured, or he's sitting. So I threw in for Bradford because of the guy that I had on.
Yeah, you got Andrew Luck, right?
I have Luck.
Yeah, who'll be sitting
out
this week.
Right,
yeah, he's out
right,
against, so, against the Rams, actually.
I wanted somebody, and Wentz, whatever these points mean, Bradford was well above Wentz and had a great preseason.
Yeah, that's fine. You can't really put a lot of stock into preseasons, but it's okay.
It.
What I would do is probably in that case, I would probably chuck Luck for a while because they don't know if he's going to play at all. But you can technically get through just the season with one quarterback, and then when your quarterback has a bye week, just pick up another one and just play the matchup that week. That's typically what I will do.
Really?
So, yeah, so if you're sitting there and your starter's at week 8 or week 10, sit him that week, and then whoever is like that hot quarterback, maybe nobody's got Marcus Mariota, maybe nobody's got Jay Cutler in your league, probably a lot of people won't.
Yeah.
But you know he's playing really well and finally fitting in Miami's offense. You can pick him for that week, drop one of your lesser guys, but by that time you probably had some guys, a receiver, tight end, or running back that's gotten hurt. Just swap him out for that 1 week and then go back to your starter. I mean, that's typically what you want to do because you'd rather load your bench, and this is what's helped me in the past. You'd rather load your bench with talented players and position players, the flex guys, so then you can – hopefully trade if at some point down the road you might get an injury to a main guy, you could trade out with someone else in your league to pick up a solid player.
Gotcha. Yeah, once I learned like the philosophy and like how this kind of sways and works, because this is really different. The only one I've ever done before is a soccer fantasy, and it's a completely different game.
That's for girls.
Oh, that's me.
There we go. There's the turn.
Whatever you say.
No, who would be the sleepers out there that may not have been picked up during your draft that would be sitting there out there just waiting to be picked up that should be on your bench maybe, starters.
You're saying available players right now.
Yeah, available players right now. Yeah.
That snuck through the draft.
Yeah, so I'll give you a great example of a guy that I tell everyone to pick up. Is a guy named Evan Engram. He's the tight end for the New York Giants. Not a lot of people probably picked him up because everybody's going with the Kelseys, the Gronkowskis, the Delanie Walkers, the Jimmy Grahams at tight end. You can get Evan Engram, who's a rookie right now for the Giants, who he'll go into the season as a starter. They cut Will Tye, who actually now got cut and will start for the Jets. But if you get Evan Engram, he's had a great – he did have a great preseason. I don't put a lot of stock into that. But for a rookie, I do when it comes to the tight end with the Giants. Eli Manning's got to find somebody to throw to. They haven't had a legit tight end for a couple years there. Mm-hmm. This guy's going to be a guy I think is going to put up – he'll put up double-digit points probably most weeks. He's a great athlete, and he's a tough mismatch for a lot of linebackers. So that's a guy just off the top of my head that if I was sitting there and he's available pretty much in – I would say probably – 99% of people's drafts. That's a guy you could, if you like Moon, you want to get rid of one of your quarterbacks, you want to get rid of a couple defenses.
Pick up this guy.
You can pick up this guy, and you're going to, and he might not pay dividends right off early, but everybody, that's the hard part. When people draft, they get so fired up about game one, right? Okay, I got to get Brady. I got to get, you know, the big name
it's
guys.
Long season.
It's a long season, and there's going to be guys that get hurt. This weekend, there's going to be a major injury, unfortunately, to somebody. You got to have some of those role players, some of those backup guys that have to step into that role, and those are the guys you kind of want to try to start doing it. And if you can think ahead of time, then again, you have now action that you can use if you want to make a trade somewhere. Somebody goes, dude, I'm looking at your bench. You got all these guys. I need a tight end. I need a receiver. What can you give me? And that's how you can kind of
work.
So, Brad,
you're saying that Marc, what's his name?
Evan Engram from
Marc
the Giants.
Marc Engram, I'm thinking.
Yeah, he's available.
Marc Engram is available as well.
Is he still playing? Is Mark Bavaro still playing? Is he still available?
Yeah, he's still throwing around manhole covers. That was his workout in the offseason.
He throw around manhole covers?
Yeah, Notre Dame guy. Yeah, he looks like it, too. He looks like that guy.
Yeah.
If you ever saw him.
To throw around manhole covers. Nice.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
It's a little cliche. That's why I don't do it.
Well, I'm excited about it. I'll tell you guys what else I'm excited about, though. I did the last year, so I won the Hot Shots Pick'em Challenge.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Wow.
And so your guys is the best, though. The one you guys got on the website is phenomenal. So I'm, of course, in that league again. A little bummed that I wasn't on the VIP page, but that's fine.
I mean, tell Web Dude to put Bridge on the VIP page.
You'll have to text me your username.
Yeah.
And your
login. I'm pretty sure it's Bridge, but well, I don't know.
Okay. I'll have him look into it.
It's a good guess.
It's Hunky Bridge 69.
Exactly right. Exactly right. Yeah, that's. I appreciate being on the show twice, man. I was like, you guys read my Freak of the Week ad. I was really excited. I like that Moon likes the fact that I like to rhyme. I thought that was really good.
You were the one looking for a ride to work.
Yeah.
That wasn't you.
I just thought I was actually laughing about that in the car. Because my whole point, I was hoping that she would say, "And no Chinese because you're horrible drivers." Like, that's what I was hoping she was going to say.
All right. Oh, yeah.
Stereotypes hurting hard.
You're talking about the grandma one.
Yeah.
Damn.
1057thepoint.com/picks to make your picks in the Riz Show Pick'em Challenge. But, all right, who do you got this week?
So, if you're sitting there right now, New England's, I think they're playing at home, and New England is a favorite to win the AFC totally East, but they're going to win, I think, the whole AFC. I do think Kansas City is a good team, and this is one of Patrico and I had this conversation when we were doing the Wing Ding, and he was talking to me about doing some fantasy picks. Kareem Hunt, I told him, I said, I think Kareem Hunt, who's the running back of Kansas City, I think he's going to get a lion's share of the carries. And this was before Spencer Ware even got hurt. And so I was, I told Patrico, let's get him in any of your leagues. He's going to be on display tonight. I think he'll have a big game. They're going to give him a lion's share of the carries. So I definitely think Kareem Hunt will help them. I don't think they're going to win. You look around the rest of the league, I don't know what games you have, but I do think the Cowboys will win. I think they're the favorite to win the NFC. If you're running down this thing, I would say I think the Redskins beat the Eagles. I think the Dolphins, of course, Buccaneers, unfortunately, are set aside for till week 11.
So they were thinking about moving that game because of the hurricane, and I guess they couldn't get it together in time. So Tampa Bay and Miami have the same bye week,
which is incredible, by the way. I mean, the fact that they did the schedule that works out that way is so rare. It's
so
incredible.
They'll play during their bye week. Yep. So that means the teams will have to play 16 games in a row.
Yeah, that's going to be, and the unions already probably have an issue with that. But I mean, there's really nothing else you can do with that short of notice. I mean, it's just Mother Nature. But that's going to be a long season. And what's hard for players is you kind of look forward to that bye week just to get a break, just because even though the rules have changed and it's not as physical as it was when I played, you still like some time away, right? And they were going to get a week off. Like Dirk Cutter, the head coach of Tampa Bay, said that week 11, the coaches wanted adjustment and rest. Now they were giving the guys 4 weeks off today, hopefully to get them out of Florida just to move them. But now then you got to come back, and hopefully you can get the guys safe back into town just for next week, because you don't know how long this thing's going to hang over Florida. So the Miami Hurricane, or I mean not Miami Hurricanes, Miami Dolphins, those guys got to go back. If they can get back, they might not be able to practice till next Wednesday. You don't know if something's going to happen to their facility. You don't know anything. So, I mean, this is going to throw them off for a long time.
So you're saying the game was more physical when you were playing it than now?
Oh, I think there's no question, because we could do 2 days. We could. The off season was a lot longer, and we started when I was playing for the Dolphins with Jimmy Johnson. We started training camp right after the 4th of July. Now those guys don't start till the beginning of August. So I mean, it's this. So that's why even now though, you still it's the guys are bigger, stronger, faster than they are when I played. But that still being said, you still want some time off, and you probably plan. I mean, there's guys that plan their off season around, you know, their vacation. Some guys plan weddings. Some guys plan a lot of stuff on that bye week to go 16 weeks in a row. That's gonna have to adjust. They're gonna have to, both teams are gonna have to adjust their practice schedule the rest of the season just to give guys a little chance to get off their feet.
You know what's fascinating? We talked about this during the wing ding. How many practices do you think an NFL team could have during the course of the entire season with pads on?
Full pads.
Full pads. Full contact practices. How many?
Eight
for the whole season.
Wow.
Yep. I mean, they've just the union's changed it, and the NFL's agreed. They're trying to keep guys healthy. I mean, that's the one thing. You talk to veteran guys now. That's why these guys that's why it won't surprise me if Tom Brady plays till he's 45, just because he can have, you know, a lot of days off, and it's not as physical. But that still said, you take some shots in games, it's still pretty tough.
And Tom Brady sucks too, man.
Good point.
I hate that.
I just like
it. I know. When somebody says Tom Brady sucks. He certainly does not suck. You may not like him. You may root against him, but he certainly does not suck.
I appreciate his wife, so nice job, Tom
and
Brady.
And he's a very nice-looking wife. Let's go through some of these games real quick. Some of the games that are going to be kind of iffy when in terms of picking goes. So you said Redskins over Eagles.
Yes.
What about the Rams and Colts?
Well, only
they're in LA.
Only just for our buddy Corey at DB's. I really hope that, you know, the Colts win this one. But at that being said, I think it's going to be tough because they're going with Scott Tolzien is going to be the starter for the Indianapolis Colts, of course, who filling in for Moon's fantasy quarterback Andrew Luck. So I think that's going to be a tough one. But that being said, they don't have Aaron Donald. Aaron Donald, the stud defensive tackle for the Los Angeles Rams, is holding out for a bigger contract, so he will not be there. They're actually going to be starting a rookie free agent. So I still think the Rams will have enough to win because I think Todd Gurley is a legit running back. I think last year was an offshoot, and then they ended up getting rid of Greg Robinson, was a former first-round pick. So I think their offensive line is going to be better. I don't think it's going to be a high-scoring game. I think it's probably – this is one of those games – 17-14, maybe 14-10. I do think the Rams end up winning it, but I just it's because I don't think the Colts, they don't have, I don't know if you can ride Frank Gore. Their offensive line, they've shuffled their whole offensive line this last 2 weeks, and I just don't know if I mean, you got T.Y. Hilton, who's everybody has got on fantasy. He's one of the top guys in fantasy. I just don't know if Tolzien's just a good enough quarterback to really make a difference in that game.
All right, what about Packers-Seahawks in Green Bay?
Yeah, I think this is a great game. This is two of the best two teams in the NFC in the last probably decade. So if it was me, in your guys' pick-ems, I took Seattle. I just think Russell Wilson will be a difference maker, and I just think they have – their defense is just so legit.
Even
in Green Bay. I think Seattle's defense is if not the best in the NFL. You know, they're in the top three at least.
All right. Is Joe Flacco playing?
Joe Flacco is playing, yes.
All right. Ravens-Bengals.
Yeah, I think the Ravens for sure. I like what the Ravens have done on their defense. I thought they brought in Eric Weddle, and they brought in Weddle was there last year, but they brought in Tony Jefferson from the Arizona Cardinals. They've made some moves along their defensive line and along their linebacking core. I think their defense will be good enough to contain Cincinnati's offense. And Cincinnati's playing without their, you know, Burfleck, their suspended linebacker, who was one of the best linebackers in the NFL. He was suspended for 3 games for a hit in the offseason or in the preseason. So I would go Baltimore there.
Man, so far that's the only one that I agree on. As of yet, but remember, I'm picking based on which mascot will beat up the other mascot.
Yeah, good. And that's fair. And again, just remember, we're not picking soccer. You know that, right? These are NFL picks.
All right, I did all right last year.
Yeah, okay. The Sunday night game, Giants-Cowboys.
Yeah, I think Cowboys are, because with Ezekiel Elliott being able to be eligible to play in this game, I think that's the difference. I really do. I think it's going to be, we're getting to see the debut of Jalen Smith, the linebacker who was, you know, out last year, he was my favorite player in the 2016 draft. He missed the whole year last year because of an injury that happened in a bowl game. He'll be playing a lot at middle linebacker. I just think the Cowboys have too much firepower on both offense and their defense to not win that game. And I think that's going to be – I really do, but I do think it comes down to – I know a lot of people are hyped on Philadelphia. I think there's a lot of people are hyped on the Redskins. I think NFC East will be the best division. This is going to be – I think this the rest of the season, these are going to be dogfight games.
All right, the two Monday games, Saints-Vikings?
Yeah, I'm not a – I just don't see where the Minnesota. I know they had a good, solid year last year, and I really like Mike Zimmer as a head coach, and because he's a great defensive coordinator. But I just think the Saints just have too much firepower. I think they're going to come out. I think Drew Brees to Michael Thomas is going to have a big night. You know, Michael Thomas had a breakout year last year, and made Brandon Cooks expendable, and Brandon Cooks, and of course, goes to New England. So I'm a big fan of that, and it's also the return of Adrian Peterson. You know, back to the NFL, but playing. You know, in Minnesota, I think that's going to be. I think that's a big highlight game. I think they're going to make a big deal about that on Monday night.
Yeah, I got something on that in a couple minutes here.
Yeah, and then in the other game, I just think that I don't like who the Broncos put at quarterback. Trevor Siemian.
It's Broncos Chargers in Denver.
Yep, and I'm not a big fan of Trevor Siemian. I just think Phillip Rivers is just too. He's just still too good. I like the return of Keenan Allen at receiver. I just think that team is going to be. I kind of think that could be a blowout. I think the Chargers could blow the Broncos out.
All right, Patrick, I want you to write these down. Mm-hmm. All right, so the NFL season kicks off tonight. First game is the Patriots versus the Chiefs.
Mm-hmm.
So Marc Lillibridge right here is going to make his predictions. Who's going to win the NFC East?
The NFC East will be Dallas Cowboys.
Central.
It will be the Pittsburgh Steelers.
West.
It will be the Oakland Raiders.
All right. AFC East.
That will be, New England's going to win the whole thing. So, yep.
Okay. Central?
Who? AFC?
AFC Central.
Yeah, no, I already picked Pittsburgh. We already got that.
Pittsburgh?
Now we're done. So now we got to go NFC.
I thought we already did NFC.
Nope, we did AFC.
No. You did NFC East, Dallas.
Okay, yep. Got who do you got?
AFC West, Oakland.
Got it, yep.
AFC Central, Pittsburgh.
Got it.
And then New England.
Now I got myself freaking confused.
Yeah, you confused me like all that could be. You did NFC East and then AFC Central.
Right, who are we missing?
And then
damn
AFC
it.
West.
I wanted to go NFC then AFC.
You were all over the place there. AFC Central.
Boone, you want to take over?
Yeah. So I'm thinking in the center
guru. AFC
left
East.
Over.
Who are we missing? The
by the water.
Did you go AFC?
So, the Norris Division.
The South.
Yeah, AFC South is. AFC South. I'll take the Tennessee Titans.
Jacksonville, good pick, man. Nope. Good pick.
Are the Browns? Are the Browns going to be as garbage as they were last year?
I think they're going to be really close.
All right,
yes.
NFC South.
I have no.
But I don't think they'll be as bad as the Jets. I think the Jets are the worst team.
Really?
Yeah, or Buffalo Bills. So say that again.
Sorry, NFC Rich. South.
NFC South. I'm going to go with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Wild cards.
We still got. Don't we have a couple more to do?
We
have NFC
South,
NFC East. West, right?
NFC West, yes. NFC West.
NFC West will be the. That'll be the Seattle Seahawks. Even though I do think Arizona's going to be legit.
West, South, East,
and the North. I'll go with the Green
North.
Bay Packers.
NFC North.
NFC That's North it. Is the Green Bay Packers.
All right,
we're good. Now the wild cards.
All right, now the wild cards.
What about the American League?
I'm going to go with the Montreal Expos. I would say I think Arizona. I think the Cardinals are in the wild card and that's in the NFC. Just to make sure, so Riz is sure on this. And then I would probably say probably the Packers. I would take Packers in that too. No, they're winning it, so I can't do that. So
yeah,
let's
I was going to say you got them as the
let's
North
go.
Winners.
Let's do. Man, that's tough off the top of my dome. I'll say the Falcons because I have Tampa Bay winning the South. The Falcons will be the NFC wild card. And then the AFC wild cards, I would say it'll be – I think the Ravens will be one of them, and I'm going to go with the – man, that's a good one.
AFC
I'll do the Chargers.
Card.
I'll do the
– Jaguars, good pick.
Yeah. Nope. Man, Tony, I know. I love you. I think you're a great dude, but – if Jacksonville wins four games, man, they had a heck of a season.
Who's going to play in the Super Bowl?
I think the natural pick is you go Cowboys and the Patriots because they're both legit. I think this is the Raiders' year. I think Oakland will play in it for the AFC, and then NFC, man. It's wide open in the NFC, but I'm going to say it's going to be. I think it's going to be somebody surprising. I think it's going to be a team like the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Oakland, Tampa Bay, snoozer.
In Minneapolis, that'd be kind of cool.
And who wins?
I think the Raiders.
Raiders.
That's my out of the box sleeper.
Bridges.
Bridges
Super Bowl champion.
It's too easy to
Oakland Raiders.
It's too you can't just pick the favorites. You got to go outside the box a little bit.
All right, so outside of the box. So set your fantasy football lineups while you're at work today before the game tonight. If you aren't in a football pool this year, USA Today has your gambling fix covered, and they just put out a list of amusing prop bets you can make before the season launches. So here's a couple highlights. So the odds that Tom Brady and Roger Goodell, the NFL commissioner, voluntarily shake hands on the field before the game. It's a 7-2 or 22% chance. So if you bet $100, you could take home $350 if they shake hands. And the two of them shook hands after the Patriots won the Super Bowl, but they basically had to in order to avoid an awkward situation. The over-under on consecutive seconds, Patriots fans boo Goodell at tonight's game. Yeah, the over-under is 35.5 seconds.
I'm taking that over for sure.
Yeah.
The odds on Minnesota Viking fans' reaction to Adrian Peterson when he shows up with the Saints on Monday night. It's 1-5 for a standing ovation. Boos are 19-1. Indifference 50-1. And none of the above 9-1. I'm going to take standing ovation at 1-5.
I mean, he's a great player. Maybe their best player in their history. So, I mean, he's at least top five. So, I would think they give him a standing ovation.
The odds on Aaron Rodgers still having a mustache.
That's a bet. You can actually make that bet.
1-3, by the way, 75%. And those are pretty good odds, especially since it looks like he already shaved it off. The odds that the Pittsburgh Steelers go for two after their first touchdown. Those are 3-1 odds.
Why that team and why that?
Because they're playing the Browns and the Browns are terrible.
Oh, all right.
The odds are that the three worst teams, the Browns, the Jets, and the 49ers, all win in week one.
That's got to be big odds.
58-1.
Yeah, I was going to say.
1.7%.
There's no way that's happening.
Or they all lose. It's 3-2 odds.
Yeah, that's a bet I would take.
The odds that the Browns finish with 9 or more wins, which basically means they make the playoffs for the first time in 15 years, 15-2 or 15%. The over-under on games that the Jets will be favored to win this season. 0.5.
Yeah.
The over-under on missed extra point kicks in week one. 4.5. And the odds that Tony Romo was incorrect in his first coach's challenge as an announcer. 3-1. He's making his debut in the Oakland, Tennessee game, by the way. So those are just some interesting prop bets. If you want to go to USA Today's website, you could find more. But all right, so I appreciate the insight. Everybody set your lineups. All good for tonight's game. We all right? Any more questions for Bridge?
What do you do with Zeke? What do you do? Do you keep him on your team and hope that it...
I think he plays all 16 games.
Yep, that's what I think too. So
I drafted him first round in one of my other fantasy things just because I think the legalities will come down tomorrow that we'll find out if they're going to put a stay on it. They'll do almost the same thing that happened to Brady for a year where he was suspended. They got it a stay, then they get it to the offseason, and then we'll see where it takes place next year. But I think Zeke plays all 16. I'll be very, very surprised if he doesn't play all 16 at least this season. It's just too much. Jerry Jones has too much juice. He's got a lot of power. And so I just think I think he plays all 16. Now, I could be wrong, but I think there's too much legality to just all of a sudden just, boom, bring it down, decision down, and then not let it play out in a court of not only public opinion, but the actual U.S. court system.
Right. Hey, make sure you make your picks for our Pick'em Challenge, 1057thepoint.com/picks. What are we going to plug? You got your Elite
just say,
Academy.
If anybody's got questions for me, if anybody's got questions at NFL Bridge on Twitter, you can find me there or on Instagram. So if somebody's got questions, you got fantasy, you need some help or something setting your lineup, I'll give it away for free. Love helping out people, and I want people to win their league. And hopefully then you can buy me a beer if you do.
Right. Okay. That's great. Yeah. And you can always see Bridge out and about. Always sitting at DB's or Hot Shots.
I was going to say, I'm sure he's going to come hang out with me at DB's.
Right.
Watching some Sunday football this year. So. Right.
Well, I appreciate the insight. Well, we'll talk to you throughout the season.
All right. I appreciate it, guys. Thanks for having me on.